Thanks for watching. I'm meteorologist Jacqueline Thomas. Heading through the day, of course, we were damp. We had showers, areas of drizzle, and as we head through the night tonight, the rain only picks up. It gets heavier. We see steady rain, and we see the winds continue to pick up tonight, too. So impact weather as we head through the rest of the evening and the overnight hours. We're talking a good 2 to 4 inches of rain possible in spots by the time things are all said and done. Strong wind gusts pick up, especially right along the coast and as you head towards the mountains and some of those areas downwind of the mountains where gusts could exceed 40 miles per hour. And with the heavy rain, localized flooding could be a concern with the wind, scattered outages. So we do have a flood watch, that dark green color across most of the state, those little blips of light green that you see. Those are individual flood warnings that will be in effect through the night tonight and tomorrow for area rivers and streams that tend to see those flooding concerns with the heavy rain. So that's something we'll be watching through the night tonight, is the potential for any flooding, not only along area rivers and streams, but also spots that are low-lying, areas that develop ponding or standing water on roadways. So if you do have to travel late tonight, just use caution and go slow. Satellite and radar, of course, has been active today with the scattered showers and the drizzle. The downpours, for the most part, have still been off to the south and off to the east, but we're going to get in on some of that heavier rain as the night goes on. Through the night, temperatures will mainly be in the 40s with the rain coming down at a good clip overnight. And as far as the rainfall goes, this is future rain, so additional rainfall from what we've already seen to this point. And you could see an additional 2 to 3 inches in spots up near the mountains. The Conway area especially could see some of the heaviest rain bands set up later tonight, but easily a good inch or more expected across most of the state as we head through the rest of the night and into early tomorrow. So the future cast taking us through this evening, you'll start to notice steadier bands of rain starting to work their way in. Those oranges and reds especially showing the heaviest rainfall potential, where we're really going to see a deluge of rain and just those torrential downpours during the overnight hours. Here's 1 a.m. So it's after midnight that we really see steady torrential rain across a good portion of the state. But as we head into early Monday, this quickly starts to move out. And so that is the good thing, that the heavy, heavy rain won't last all that long. As we head into the early morning hours Monday, we'll start to see the heaviest rain move out. It'll taper back to lingering lighter rain and showers and occasional downpours through about 6-7 o'clock in the morning, especially for the northern half of the state. But by midday, you're hanging on to clouds north of the Lakes region, but you're breaking back into sunshine as you head south. And we're going to see warmer temperatures on Monday, too. As the afternoon goes on, we'll likely see clouds building in again, and then the chance for a couple of pop-up showers late in the day or Monday evening. The wind, a second component to this, as we mentioned, we could see some gusts exceeding 40 miles per hour in spots, especially as you head right along the coast. Could even see a gust around 50 there. And then as you head downwind to the mountains, north and west of the Whites, you could see gusts 40 to 50 miles per hour. But still, gusts 30 to 40 miles per hour across most other spots in the state. So significant winds on top of the heavy rain and any branches that already have their leaves or are blooming could mean occasional power outages in some spots. Tomorrow, temperatures get back into the 60s, so at least we break out of the pattern temporarily, but precipitation chances really stick around the rest of the week, Tuesday, Wednesday, even into Thursday, before potentially next weekend could be drier and a little bit warmer again.